5, 4, 3.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Cutting Edge Concerts New Music Festival 2021. This is a new experience for all of us because part of it is live and part of it is
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Cutting Edge Concerts New Music Festival 2021. This is a new experience for all of us because part of it is live and part of it is
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Cutting Edge Concerts New Music Festival 2021. This is a new experience for all of us because part of it is live and part of it is Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Cutting Edge Concerts New Music Festival 2021. This is a new experience for all of us because part of it is live and part of it is Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Cutting Edge Concerts New Music Festival.
Performed by trombonist Joseph Alessi and pianist Martha Locker. Welcome, Jorge.
Part of it is Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Cutting Edge Concerts New Music Festival.
Bonus, so impressed with Alessi and pianist
you
Martha
are
Locker.
A trumpet player.
Welcome, yeah. But you Jorge. Obviously know a
part of it is Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Cutting Edge Concerts New Music Festival.
He's the assistant director of jazz studies at the University of Nevada, Las Vegas. He teaches both classical trombone and jazz trombone, as well as jazz composition, which he's originally my jazz composition teacher.
Yeah. Great. And you had mentioned the name Adelante. By the way, I'd like to mention also that we have program notes, bios, all sorts of interesting information. If you go to www.cuttingedgeconcerts.org, you will see the program and can look at the program notes and bios of all the performers and composers on tonight's concert. So the name Adelante, did it start out meaning what it now means, or did that change?
I think it throughout the writing process, it started developing a new meaning for me. You know, when I first wrote this, I started during the pandemic. You know, last year there was, it was I think at its height, and there was also a lot of, civil unrest happening with, a lot of things. And Adelante is a Spanish word that translates to moving forward. And it to me, it kind of has a double meaning. You know, when moving forward is one, but the other meaning is, in my household, in Spanish, when we greet someone into our home, we say Adelante. You know, we greet our guests to come in into our home. So it's a double meaning of moving forward, but also greeting others to welcome them into our home and to kind of have this unity camaraderie. So that's really the meaning of that word, and that's what I hope for all of us to come forward or to move adelante.
Exactly. Well, I'd like to welcome you all into Jorge Machain's piece Adelante. Thank you so
Thank
much
you,
for being here, and
Thank
please
you.
Welcome to the stage Joseph Alessi and Martha Locker.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. That was Joseph Alessi, principal trombone of the New York Philharmonic, and pianist Martha Locker playing Jorge Machain Adelante. Thank you so much. Well, our stage is going to be filled with another great trombonist, John Romano, who is going to perform a piece of Harrison Collins, Harrison J. Collins. And I'd like to remind you that at www.cuttingedgeconcerts.org, you can find the complete program and program notes and bios and of the performers and of the composers. And I would like to welcome to the stage our next composer, Harrison J. Collins, and his piece... Thank you. Thank you. We do have an audience out there.
Thank you.
And his piece, The Beginning of Spring. How appropriate. Here we are at the beginning of spring. Now, Harrison has written wonderful, extensive program notes, but we're so happy to have him here live to talk about the piece. So tell us something. It goes all the way from the Renaissance up through present time.
It does. The Renaissance music, the piece begins with Renaissance music, which was a discussion that John and I had. Whenever I write for a soloist, I want to make sure that if they have suggestions that can make the music more special to them, that I honor that. And so we discussed the idea of including Renaissance music, and I took the opportunity to include O Magnum Mysterium by the arrangement of the text by Tomas Luis de Victoria.
My namesake.
Yeah, as a way of representing uncertainty throughout a work that is about many things, but particularly is about uncertainty.
Gee, we can't imagine what that would be like today, right? Here we are in an uncertain time.
I completed the work in 2018, and it was about the... many feelings that I have felt as a young American in the U.S., but also in the context of the U.S. in the world, and about our continuing experiences in a place very often defined by tension and divisiveness. And it was coincidence that the pandemic should happen not more than weeks after I finished the work, and certainly tension and divisiveness increased in that time. But I wanted to write a work that summarized the feelings I've had, and you'll hear throughout the work, each movement explores these feelings. The first explores frustration and anger, but also resolve to do good and to change. And the second explores resignation and sadness, but also reflection. And the third explores anxiety. And underpinned by the entire thing is the feeling of hope. And the hope, my hope, is that the work purveys my core belief when I think about this tension and divisiveness, which is that hope, in the end, is the correct response to this difficulty.
Thank you so much. Yes, we all need that hope right now. And thank you for giving it to us in your composition. So I would like to welcome to the stage John Romano, accompanied by Hanako Yamagata Greenberg on the piano. Thank you so much.
And if I may, John Romero.
I'm sorry.
No, it's okay.
John Romero. Yes, forgive me.
I get it all. It's fine.
John Romero.
Thank you. Thank you.
Romero. John Romero, principal trombone of the New York, of the Metropolitan Opera Orchestra, accompanied by Hanako Yamagata Greenberg, performing Harrison J. Collins, The Beginning of Spring. Thank you so much, John. So Kenneth Fuchs, who is the composer of our next work, the bass trombone concerto, could not be here today, but he has sent a short video introduction, which we will go to now. And afterwards, we will hear George Curran, bass trombone of the New York Philharmonic, accompanied by Hanako Greenberg, perform Kenneth Fuchs' bass trombone concerto.
Hello, I'm Kenneth Fuchs. I'm delighted to join Cutting Edge Concerts on April 12th for the performance of my bass trombone concerto by George Curran, bass trombonist of the New York Philharmonic. The work was commissioned by a consortium of 21 bass trombonists throughout the United States. It exists in versions for orchestra, band, and with piano accompaniment. And that is the version that you're going to hear on the concert, the New York premiere of the bass trombone concerto with piano. I'm delighted to have this opportunity, and I hope you can tune in to hear this work and all of the wonderful pieces on the concert. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. That was George Curran, bass trombone of the New York Philharmonic, performing Kenneth Fuchs' bass trombone concerto, and Hanako Yamagata Greenberg was at the piano. Thank you both so much. Brilliant performance. Well, Anthony Barfield, who is the composer of our next work, could also not be here. As I said, this was going to be a mixture of live and virtual, but he did send a video, a short video talking about his piece, Red Sky, which is going to be performed by Colin Williams, associate principal of the New York Philharmonic, accompanied by the ever-present and wonderful Hanako Yamagata Greenberg. So please enjoy the video and then the performance.
Hello, everyone. My name is Anthony Barfield, the composer of Red Sky. It is an absolute honor to be a part of this year's Cutting Edge Concerts New Music Festival. A huge thanks to Victoria Bond for having me, as well as a huge thanks to my friend and colleague, Colin Williams, for performing the work. For those of you who don't know Colin's playing, you're definitely in for a treat. So I composed the original wind band version of Red Sky in 2012, and then later in 2018, my arranger completed the piano reduction. Red Sky is a 14-minute work that I based upon the Big Bang Theory, which is the scientific explanation of how our universe started. According to the theory of physics, if we were to look at the universe 1 second after the Big Bang, what we would see is a 10 billion degree sea of neutrons, protons, and electrons. Red Sky paints a picture of space, matter, and energy. But it also has a deeper meaning that basically we're all the same as human beings, and to realize that wherever we are in this world, within this large universe, that we are all connected. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was Colin Williams, Associate Principal Trombone of the New York Philharmonic, performing Anthony Barfield's Red Sky with Yamagata Greenberg at the piano. Thank you both so much. Well, I said this was going to be a mixture of live and virtual, and now we come to the virtual portion of our concert. My piece, The Voices of Air, is performed by Jodie Davis, but she was not able to be here, so she also gives a very good introduction. So rather than my giving an introduction to it, I'll just turn the whole thing over to the videotape. So please enjoy Jodie Davis performing The Voices of Air by yours truly, Victoria Bond. Dan Velliser is at the piano. Thank you, and I will be back.
Hello, Thank you for watching our video of Victoria Bond's The Voices of Air. We are pleased to perform it for this cutting-edge concert. When Victoria and I were talking about a new piece for trombone, we explored some general topics and ideas. And then I left her to it. Instinctually, she came back with one of the most significant aspects of playing the instrument, air. The piece explores various ways that air can behave to express different moods. It begins on a meditation on E and expands to a wide range, dynamically and in pitch. The joyful second movement is inspired by two facile jazz players, Irby Green and Carl Fontana. Movement three, as the title suggests, floats on a lyrical line and explores the ease of allowing air to be expressive. And finally, there is Breathless, which moves fast and jumps from place to place in a state of exhilaration. The meditation on E returns before a vigorous ending. I would like to acknowledge Victoria and express my gratitude to her for writing this clever and insightful new piece for the trombone repertoire.
Thank you.
That was trombonist Jody Davis and pianist Dan Velliser performing my composition, The Voices of Air. Thank you so much for attending tonight's performance. We were so happy that you could be part of Cutting Edge Concerts New Music Festival 2021. For information about this program, including biographies of the composers and the performers and program notes, please visit www.cuttingedgeconcerts.org. I'd like to invite you all to next week, April 19th at 7:30, right here at Symphony Space, when pianist Paul Barnes will present a program that includes Philip Glass, who will be here talking about his composition, Annunciation, and the premiere of my work, Three Illuminations on Byzantine Chant. So please join us next week, April 19th at 7:30. Good night.